Hurt quarter. Texans 10, Bengals 9. The Bengals offense finally showed life in their first drive of the second half, with Dalton marching the team down the field and chewing up plenty of clock. Tyler Eifert nearly had the team's first touchdown, but officials ruled he stepped out of bounds before catching the ball, making it a penalty. The Bengals got yet another field goal. Second quarter, Texans 10, Bengals 6. Texans 10, Bengals 6. The Bengals save a little face after their defense got burned by Watson, kicking a field goal at the end of the second quarter. Texans 10, Bengals 3. Watson finally breaks the game open with his legs, taking off on a scramble and going 49 yards to the end zone. Watson gets his biggest welcome to the NFL moment, courtesy of Geno Atkins. Nothing really happening in this game. Some poor play by Watson and Dalton, who have been off with their throws most of the night. It's a classic Thursday night football slop fest. Texans 3, Bengals 3. Cincy can't take advantage of Green's huge play and settle for a field goal, scoring their first points of the 2017 NFL season. First quarter, Texans 3, Bengals 0. Dalton ended the quarter with a beautiful bomb to AJ Green, who beat three Texans defenders because he's AJ Dang Green. Texans 3, Bengals 0. John Ross's first NFL carry could not have gone any worse. Kareem Jackson punched the ball out of his hands and Jadeveon Clowney scooped it up for a 49-yard return, setting up the Texans in field goal range. It's been an uneventful game so far, but at least we had this nifty punt return. Took until the 7:36 mark, but we finally have a first down in this game. Deonta Foreman did the honors for Houston with a 9-yard run. However, the drive stalled out when Watson ate a sack on third and long. The Bengals also started 3-and-out when Andy Dalton got sacked on a cornerback blitz on third down. The Texans went 3-and-out on their opening drive, with Watson misfiring on a couple throws. Before the game, two teams with big questions behind center meet at 8:30 p.m. ET Thursday in Cincinnati, TV, NFL Network, NBC in Houston and Cincinnati markets, with hopes of turning around a gruesome start to their 2017 seasons. The Bengals and Texans each got underwhelming performances from their quarterbacks Sunday, and somehow the worst showing wasn't from a career backup or rookie passer, but veteran Pro Bowler Andy Dalton. Dalton was historically bad against the Ravens, turning the ball over 5 times in a 20-0 home rout. His lowest moment came late in the fourth quarter where, facing a 4th-and-5 situation, he scrambled away from pressure and simply threw the ball away, eliminating any chance for a miracle comeback. Texans quarterbacks Tom Savage and Deshaun Watson weren't much better. Savage's reign as the team's starter lasted exactly 2 quarters before head coach Bill O'Brien decided he'd seen enough and inserted Watson in his place. Savage was bad 7 of 13 passing for a meager 62 yards, but it wasn't all his fault. Houston's cheesecloth offensive line allowed him to be sacked 6 times in just 2 quarters. Although Watson was able to lead the team to its only touchdown of the game, he didn't fare much better. He was sacked 4 times and needed 23 passes to gain just 102 aerial yards. However, the rookie passer has a much higher ceiling than his veteran counterpart. Savage can be an effective game manager, but Watson's uber-productive career at Clemson showed just how explosive he can be. Houston has an ace in the hole thanks to a dominant defense that will have to get back on track after allowing Jacksonville to ring up 29 points. J.J. Watt made his return to the field after missing most of 2016 with a back injury that required 2 separate surgeries, but made only 1 tackle in the opener. He also missed time after a hand injury that busted the bone through the skin. Despite that horrific description, he only missed a quarter of play. Watt will work to get back to his Defensive Player of the Year standard against Dalton, who was sacked 5 times last week. Will the Texans' ferocious pass rush be enough to bully the Bengals into another dire offensive showing? Or can Dalton make enough plays to lead his team past a rookie quarterback in his first ever start?